Hello children, welcome to your English literature class with me, Miss Bijal, your second standard English teacher. Children, today we will do workbook exercise of the lesson Curly Locks and the Three Bears. Children, in our last class, I have already taught you this lesson and told you to read the story. I hope you all have read the story from your textbook. So now, open your English workbook, page number 85, and let's read meanings. Curly, having a lot of curls. Cottage, a small house. Ball, a small deep dish to keep food. Porridge, cereal or grain boiled in milk or water. Hungry, feeling or showing the need for food. Asleep, sleeping. Gruff, rough. Woke up, to get up from sleep. Bottom, the lowest part of something, container, river, etc. Now, who said these words in the story? One is done for you. First, is anyone in Curly Locks? Second, somebody ate my porridge, said Papa Bear. Somebody ate my porridge too, said Mama Bear. Fourth, somebody finished all my porridge, said Baby Bear. Fifth, somebody slept in my bed, said Papa Bear. Sixth, somebody slept in my bed too, said Mama Bear. And seventh, somebody is sleeping in my bed. And the answer is Baby Bear. Answer the following questions. Where did Curly Locks go one day? One day, Curly Locks went into the forest. Question number 2. Who lived in the cottage in the forest? And the answer is, the bear family lived in the cottage in the forest. Third question. What did Curly Locks see on the table? And the answer is, Curly Locks saw 3 balls of porridge on the table. Fourth question, why did she eat up all the porridge from Baby Bear's bowl? And the answer is, she ate up all the porridge from Baby Bear's bowl because it was not very hot or very cold. It was just right. Question number 5, whose bed did Curly Locks sleep in and why? Curly Locks slept in Baby Bear's bed because it was not very hard or very soft. It was just right to sleep. Question number 6. What did Curly Locks do when she saw 3 bears? Answer is, she jumped down from the bed and ran out of the cottage as fast as she could. Children, you have to write down these question answers and meanings in your notebook and learn. Now look at page number 87. Word castle. There are words that have same pronunciation but different spelling and meaning. For example, C, S-E-E-C and S-E-A-C, C and C. Now, look at the other examples. Color the correct word box to complete the sentence. First, this is R family or H-O-U-R, R family. And the answer is R first, O U R, and second R means which indicates the time, 1 hour, 2 hour. Second, I sent, S C E N T, sent, or S E N T, sent a letter to my teacher, and the correct answer is S E N T, sent. I sent a letter to my teacher. Third, give me S O M E some or S U M some sugar, please. So the answer is S O M E, some sugar, which indicates the quantity, and S U M some means when you do addition in the maths, the answer you get is called S U M some. Okay, children. Now see, fourth, the lady is TWO2 or TOO2 week, and the correct answer is TOO2 means so much, and TOO2 it indicates number 2. I hope you have understood till here. Now see page number 88. I write, R-I-G-H-T, right, means right hand side, left hand side, that one. And other option is W-R-I-T-E, right, with my left hand. And the correct option is, correct answer is right, W-R-I-T-E. To use pencil and paper and note down something. Sixth, the sky is blue, B-L-U-E, blue, color. Now look below, grammar focus. Look at the picture and encircle the correct words to complete the sentences. One is done for you. The man shouted dash, quietly, sadly, quickly, or loudly. And the answer is loudly. So loudly, the word loudly explains, tells us more about how the man shouted. Shouting is verb, and loudly explains more about the verb, tells us more about the verb. So children, that is called adverb. A word that tells us something more about the verb is called adverb. Now see, look at the second question. The snail moved dash. How snail moves? Loudly, slowly, angrily, or happily? Yes, and the answer is slowly. The snail moved slowly. Third, the girl ran dash quickly, quietly, angrily, or loudly. And the answer is quickly. The girl ran quickly. Fourth, the lady sat dash slowly, quietly, quickly, or angrily. And the answer is quietly. The lady sat quietly. Fifth, the car stopped dash softly, suddenly, sadly, or quietly. And the answer is suddenly. The car stopped suddenly. That's all for today's class, children. You have to complete your English workbook with good handwriting and learn meaning and question answers. Thank you. Goodbye.